A very good evening to each and every one of you. My name is Nadia Heng, and I will be your Master of Ceremony for today's celebration of the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards 2021 Regional Edition. This is APEA's second virtual award, and it is our 15th year celebrating successes together with influential business leaders and enterprises in Asia. We are truly delighted that today's award ceremony is filled with audiences streaming in from China, Brunei, Hong Kong, India, Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, Singapore, Taiwan, Thailand, and many other parts of the region. Welcome everyone. Let us of course know below in the live comments which country are you streaming in from. Officially welcoming the award ceremony together with us are the Board of Advisor and Executive Committee of Enterprise Asia, including Tun Sri Dr. Fong Chun On, Chairman of Enterprise Asia, Richard Sung, President of Enterprise Asia, along with the Board of Advisors, Governor Tun Datuk Sri Tan Sri Ahmad Fuzi Haji Abdul Razak, Governor Gwendolyn Garcia, Dr. Eugene Chien, Lieutenant General Sudhir Sharma, Dr. Victor Wee, and Dr. Shaika Al-Maskari. This is Enterprise Asia's 16th year as the region's largest and leading non-governmental organization for entrepreneurship development. And the awards aims to really band together leading entrepreneurs across the region to spur greater innovation, fair business practices, and the growth in entrepreneurship. Primarily, the APEA is a platform to encourage continued leadership towards a sustainable economic development for the region. For you who are new to Enterprise Asia, we started in 2006, and over the past 16 years, we have grown to become one of the largest multilateral associations for entrepreneurs and enterprises. Our mission at Enterprise Asia is to champion fair and equitable entrepreneurship development in the region. At the heart of this mission is our desire to democratize entrepreneurship, empower innovation, and institutionalize sustainability. Three very important enablers if we are to create equality and equity in business, in entrepreneurship, and in nation building. So please pay attention to the screen right now as we're about to play a short introduction video of just what Enterprise Asia is all about.
At Enterprise Asia, our three pillars of purpose is entrepreneurship, sustainability, and innovation. The past 10 years has been a wonderful journey of empowering entrepreneurs, matching them with opportunities and seeing them grow. We work with governments and other organizations to democratize entrepreneurship by promoting competition and choice. We believe that the true foundation of any nation's economy lies in its entrepreneurial resources, which, if nurtured effectively, can be the most efficacious asset for sustainable economic development. Together, we aim to uplift the economic status of people across the region to ensure a legacy of hope and innovation for our children. Our network of more than 8,000 entrepreneurs and enterprises across the world represents a combined revenue of over US $50 billion. Our analysts regularly monitor close to 200,000 businesses across 24 countries and 32 different industries. We aim to identify and recognize outstanding entrepreneurial achievement and innovative enterprises as a means to rewards and encourages innovative businesses and responsible enterprises to rise up to a standard of business that prioritizes innovation and sustainability. Our global summits, such as the Enterprise Asia Summit, International CSR Summit, and the International Innovation Summit, set the global agenda on our three pillars, namely democratizing entrepreneurship, institutionalizing sustainability, and empowering innovation. The next 10 years will be about connecting businesses to the innovation ecosystem and ensuring that sustainability is ingrained into everything they do. Join us as we strive towards building a world that is rich in sustainable entrepreneurship and innovation.
Now, without further ado, may we welcome Mr. Richard Tsung, Enterprise Asia's president, to present his opening address.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Enterprise Asia, I would like to welcome you to the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards 2021, or APEA. This year also marks the 15th year of the APEA. 15 years of celebrating entrepreneurial achievements is a milestone we can all be proud of. When the awards were first introduced in the year 2007, we insisted on two important pillars of the awards. These are investment in people and responsible entrepreneurship. We knew 15 years ago that the way forward for entrepreneurs and enterprises and our interaction with the rest of the world rest in our ability to inspire and promote equity and equality in a world rife with differences and inequality. The pandemic has, among other things, highlighted wide chasm between the have and the have-nots. As business leaders, it is imperative that we continue to use the considerable influence we wield for the forces of good and to narrow the chasm that divides us. This year's theme of the APEA is the Great Reset towards a sustainable recovery. The pandemic has turned into the very foundation of our societies and our economies. But it has also brought about an opportunity for us to press the reset button, to ask ourselves if there are better ways for our wealth to be generated and distributed, and if profit should continue to be the only determinant of our success as businesses. So, how do we start for a sustainable future? There is already a global movement for shared values. ESG markets, as a means for socially responsible investing, is fast making way for integrated reporting. It may be unbelievable to some, but the same capitalist forces that have pushed profits as the sole purpose of businesses allow gambling to instill environmental and social markets to be of equal importance in businesses. However, the journey from where we are to where the proponents of sustainable business aspire to be is still a long one. This is where, as business leaders, we have the opportunity to take bold steps to reshape our economies. A socially responsible business is not only contributing to a just and equitable world, but is also what our own customers, investors, and the world at large are expecting. It is again this note and the auspicious 15th year of the APEA that we are honoring some of the best businesses and business leaders in Asia and the Pacific. You are the standards by which other businesses will be judged. The Lens Award will spur you to continue down the path of sustainable growth and leadership. Once again, congratulations to all award recipients. I wish everyone good health. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Richard, for those wonderful warm words of welcome. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you're all very eager to find out who are going to be the winners of this year's APEA 2021 Regional Edition. Now, before we do so, allow me a moment to thank our partners who have made this splendid evening possible. PR Newswire, APEA 2021 Regional Edition's news release distribution partner. Angel Investment Network, Indonesia. India Chamber of Commerce, Indonesian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Institut Keusahawanan Negara Berhad, Malaysian Investment Development Authority, Malaysian Thai Chamber of Commerce, Ministry of Entrepreneur Development and Cooperatives, National Institute of Entrepreneurship and Innovation, Cambodia, Singapore Thai Chamber of Commerce, SME Corporation, the Malaysian Chamber of Commerce, Hong Kong and Macau Limited. And of course, would also love to thank our media partners for making this event a success. Business World, the Philippines, Commercial Times, Taiwan, Daily Tribune, the Philippines, Hong Kong Economic Times, Jumpstart Hong Kong, Kumparan Indonesia, New Delhi Times India, SME Magazine, The Nation Thailand, The Standard Hong Kong, and the official production partner Avangardia Group Sindirian Berhad. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've been waiting for is here. We shall now begin presenting the awards to tonight's recipients. The Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards recipients have all gone through a stringent evaluation and judging process, including a mandatory audit by the Secretariat before being selected from among hundreds of nominees as tonight's winners. All winners tonight will join the thousands of alumni from across Asia who are now proud recipients of Asia Pacific's most prestigious awards for entrepreneurship. Before we begin, give yourselves a big round of applause for demonstrating outstanding leadership and entrepreneurial excellence across the region. Also, don't forget to like and share this live video with your friends and loved ones. Now, we shall begin the first session of the awards presentation. First, we would like to present the Corporate Excellence category. Winners under this category are the companies that demonstrate sustainable growth, responsible leadership, and operational excellence that was achieved in several strategic forms. They are, in fact, the beacon of excellence in the industry they represent. The recipients of the APEA 2021 Corporate Excellence category in alphabetical order of the enterprises they represent are, first up, AEM Holdings Limited for semiconductor industry from Singapore. Let's take a look at their success story. Sindirian Berhad for manufacturing industry from Malaysia.
From a strong legacy of continued improvement in quality and consistency, constantly moving forward in reaching new heights to be the largest roofing and buildings materials supplier, we are A Steel Group of Companies. We are certified and compliant in industry standards and recognized for our commitments and contributions to the industry. At A Steel, we manufacture and supply a wide range of materials and products that caters to all levels of building and architectural needs. A Steel specializes in the manufacturing of steel roofing and structures design and build. Our integrated facility also focuses on providing other building and construction materials to the downstream markets. From materials to products to strategic services and more, we are your partner for success.
Next, we have Bahwan Cybertech for telecommunications and ICT industry from India.
Hello everyone, on behalf of Bahwan Cybertech Asia Pacific team, I would like to thank the jury of APEA for selecting my organization as the winner for the Corporate Excellence Award category under Telecommunications and ICT Industry. I'm extremely delighted as this award serves as a recognition to our perseverance, growth, and commitment to deliver value and excellence to our customers. Winning this prestigious award will assist to further expand our footprint across Asia Pacific and continue to deliver our strategy of becoming the most preferred digital transformation partner in this region. Thank you once again for the award.
BDO Unibank Incorporated for financial services industry from the Philippines.
The Philippines moves to the beat of progress. And no one knows its pulse like BDO Unibank. With leading scale and reach, the expertise and local knowledge to connect you to Philippine business. BDO Unibank. We find ways.
Another winner from Malaysia, Grant International, Sindiran Berhad, for professional and business services industry.
Congratulations, team of Grant International, for winning this Corporate Excellence Award. So despite the pandemic and the challenges that we faced, you were able to achieve extraordinary results. For that, I want to extend my appreciation and thank you for your dedications, for your commitment and your pursuit for excellence, you know, in ensuring that the company achieved extraordinary performance. So once again, thank you and a well-deserved win.
We are Brent, making a difference and raising the bar for customer experience, one interaction at a time. That is our brand promise.
CITIC Telecom International, CPC Limited for telecommunications and ICT industry from Hong Kong. Let's check out their story. Up next, from the Philippines, Converge ICT Solutions Incorporated for telecommunications and ICT industry.
Converge ICT believe that Filipinos deserve the best connectivity. And this has been our sole purpose ever since the founding of our company. Converge ICT is the fastest growing pure play internet provider in the Philippines. We have become the largest high speed fixed broadband provider in the Philippines. And our purpose remains to provide reliable and affordable internet for each and every Filipino. We are Converge ICT, and we're inviting you to join us as we continue to uplift lives through meaningful connectivity.
Sun Financial Holding Company Limited for financial services industry from Taiwan. Singapore, we have Everrise Holdings for professional and business services industry.
Growth in a time of disruption requires evolution. Digital evolution.
Everrise is exceedingly effective at transforming customer and product experiences for the digital age.
Together, our cutting-edge technology and award-winning talent are quietly testing, protecting, supporting, and selling the products and services you use every day.
Ensuring your business never stops evolving.
We are Everrise.
Up next, Everlight Electronics Company Limited for manufacturing industry from Taiwan. Financial services industry from Taiwan.
We at Far Glory Life are extremely honored to receive the Asia Pacific Enterprise Award for Corporate Excellence. For more than 28 years in Taiwan, we are the life insurance business Far Glory Group and is committed to the development of Taiwan's life insurance market. We are dedicated and focused on having our customers live a stable life. Having a stable life is one part of our company's philosophy and purpose. We believe through dedicated efforts, while always keeping our humble beginnings in mind, Fargo realized we joined hands to build and realize dreams of our policyholders in Taiwan's every land where they exist.
Government Savings Bank from Thailand for financial services industry. Let's take a look.
Government Savings Bank was established for over 108 years with the assets of 2.8 trillion baht and capital funds of 1.8 hundred billion baht. GSB has more than 22 million customers, providing comprehensive financial services as Universal SFI with a network of service channels including 1,082 branches nationwide and digital banking. GSB has a strong performance and financial position both in assets and deposits.
The COVID-19 situation in 2020, GSB is the main driver of government measures to elevate the affected people.
These awards are the result from outstanding performance in 2020. GSB is beyond banking, it is the bank for society.
And moving on to Wuxi Stem Cell Applied Technology Company Limited for healthcare, pharmaceutical and biotechnology industry from Taiwan. WG Group Holdings for property development industry from China.
What does the future hold in store? Together we build. United we progress.
And now we have Miri Port Authority for transportation and logistics industry from Malaysia.
On behalf of the Relay Port Authority, we would like to thank the organizer, Enterprise Asia, for having selected us as the winner for the transportation and logistics industry sector in the Corporate Excellence Award category. We owe this award achievement to so many people, especially for the great and wonderful team I have in the Relay Port Authority. The board of directors, management and staff, our customers, business associates and all stakeholders. This award inspires us to do more towards achieving our vision to be a world transport by 2030. Thank you, Enterprise Asia.
Up next, Wong Thai Life Assurance Public Company Limited for financial services industry from Thailand.
On behalf of Wong Thai Life Assurance, I'm very grateful to know that we have been received the Corporate Excellence Award of 2021 on this year. It is something that we as Wong Thai Life, we are so proud of. Yes, this award has meaningful to all of us in a way that the world has changing a lot with all the dynamic environment, including all the COVID-19 effect that also having a lot of the challenging and also opportunity on this thing. By receiving this award, it's something that, I mean, to us, it's something that what we are doing is probably something on the right direction, and it's something to give as a incentive back to ourselves that we are doing something on the right way on this thing. So thanks a lot to all the judges and all the people that giving on this award to us, and we also very committed that what we are doing is to the best of the policyholder and to the best of all the Thai people, or if we have a chance to answer to all the ASEAN country also on this thing. So thanks a lot.
National Bank of Bahrain, Bahrain Shareholding Company for Financial Services Industry from Bahrain.
National Bank of Bahrain, Bahrain Shareholding Company for Financial Services Industry from Bahrain. National Bank of Bahrain, BSC NBB, is the country's first locally owned bank and has been supporting the kingdom's economy for over 60 years, spearheading financial presence across Bahrain and expanding to key Gulf Corporation Council markets. The bank's continuous efforts towards its human capital development and digital transformation journey has launched its open banking solutions, the first in MENA region, converting it into a leading customer-centric institute. Today, NBB is commended of its strategic shift as a customer-centric, digitally capable, modern and accessible banking institution with a unique value proposition for everyone it serves.
Next, Pasaraya MM Sindiran Berhad for retail industry from Malaysia. Financial services industry from Indonesia.
It's an honor to be nominated Corporate Excellence Thank you, APEA, for the nominations. Indonesia is a very vast country with diverse cultures, traditions, and innumerable behavioral nuances. With whopping 260 million people plus, banking can be a challenge. But we see this challenge as an opportunity. Our pursuit to corporate excellence not just stems from inspiring these people by providing access of banking to them, but also being inspired by their nuances so that we solve their financial problems. And we are purpose-built to do so. Our mission is to provide banking services to not only those who want, but also to those who need. This further bolsters our underlying philosophy at Amar Bank that technology must not just create experiences, but also should impact in people's life for better. Hence, we have set out on a journey to make our vision a reality by bringing 200 million smiles by end of 2025.
PT Mora Telematika Indonesia for telecommunications and ICT industry from Indonesia.
Since 2008, Moratelindo has grown globally, owning its own 48,515-kilometer fiber optic network stretching from west to east Indonesia, with a total 18,360 Gbps DWDM capacity, all connected to 361 points of presence, including 6 own national data centers. Then, in 2016, the Indonesian government trusted Moratelindo to running a national strategic project by appointing Moratelindo as the winner of the West Palapa and East Palapa tenders. Moratelindo is also successful in running ducting cable of Semarang on the trust of the local government to Moratelindo, built it in 362 roads of the city. After this, Moratelindo will continue to try to develop and meet the needs of Indonesian nation and state. Sure we can.
PT AXA Financial Indonesia for financial services industry from Indonesia.
Thank you to the Asia Pacific Enterprise Award 2021 for choosing AXA Financial Indonesia in the corporate excellence category. During this crisis time, we have all prioritized the health and well-being of our employees, partners, and customers. But as an insurance company, we've had this added responsibility to make sure we are standing with our customers, providing them the comprehensive cover during this, what I call as a moment of truth. We have also had strategy which have been adaptive and agile, responding to the current situation, whether it was acceleration of our digital agenda, or it was about adapting to the new style of working, or making sure we come up with more and new proposition relevant to these times. I'm very honored to receive this award on behalf of the entire team. This award is going to go a long way in motivating us in doing our best. It goes without saying that we would not have achieved this without the incredible teamwork that we have put together, teamwork of our employees, trust of our customers, and a great immense support of our shareholder AXA. Thank you.
Quantum Automation Private Limited for telecommunications and ICT industry from Singapore. Reju Construction Company Limited for construction industry from Taiwan.
建筑是百年的传承，梦想的延续。身为甲级营造业的瑞筑营造，以专业的建筑品质与服务闻名业界。一直以来，瑞筑善尽企业责任，发挥1+1大于2的影响力，持续投身公益。在全球 COVID-19 疫情冲击下，以产业优势结合医护需求，为防疫尽一份心力。
面对环境变化，瑞筑仍有强大适应力。从核心能力出发，运用创新差异化策略，由营造跨界绿能经济，善尽产业价值，带领企业渡过挑战。30年来，瑞筑营造历经9.2大地震、金融海啸及新冠肺炎，不畏风雨，连续16年营收正成长。瑞筑营造期许能创造出一个与环境共生、 与企业共好，与社会共荣的一个永续发展，迎接领航，展翅飞扬。Rizal
Commercial Banking Corporation, or RCBC, for financial services industry from the Philippines.
RCBC has always been driven to serve with passion and purpose, with the end goal of promoting inclusive prosperity through innovative banking. We endeavor to always do better every day. And as the saying goes, excellence is a gradual result of always striving to do better. It is therefore with honor and a grateful heart that we accept this award. This is not just for RCBC, but also for all Filipinos whom we serve, who are proven resilient amidst the pandemic. Thank you to the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards for recognizing our efforts and empowering our people and enabling a sustainable digital Philippines. Mabuhay!
Xiang Auto Parts Company Limited for manufacturing industry from Taiwan.
我是来自台湾志祥公司总经理周哲宏，在这里首先非常感谢亚洲企业商会评审团的肯定，让我们公司得到这个奖项的殊荣。志祥公司成立在1980年代，专业生产汽车 底盘悬吊系统，并且成功行销全世界77国。志祥的成长优势在于拥有先进模具设计中心，透过数位化的验证 ，CAE 的模拟，可以最快推出我们创新的产品。在我背后就是我们最新的斗南智慧制造中心，占地5万平方米。我们运用 5G 联网技术与自动化生产设备，加上自动仓储， 让我们产能一举突破500万 piece， 我们积极落实企业社会责任，以实践幸福企业、客户满意的永续发展价值。最后，我还是要感谢亚洲企业商会评审团的肯定，让我们有持续进步的动力。谢谢大家，谢谢。
Next, Srikota Specialist Medical Center for Healthcare, Pharmaceuticals and Biotechnology Industry from Malaysia.
It's a great honor to receive the Corporate Excellence Award for the very first year from the most prestigious business award in the region. I would like to thank the Asia Pacific Enterprise Award Committee for your recognition of Srikota as an organization that is able to deliver status while staying true to our core purpose of delivering healthcare excellence to all our patients. This award is dedicated to everyone at Srikota Specialist Medical Center for their hard work and effort in enhancing our hospital vision and mission. as this achievement would be impossible without each and every one of their working together to benefit the community we serve.
Taiwa Public Company Limited for Agriculture Industry from Thailand.
For over 70 years, Taiwa has been innovating new products and categories to serve the global market with our food and starch products and with our hallmark brands, Rose, Double Dragon, Phoenix, and Double Kirin. We trust that the essential key to success are ultimately our people and our culture. Our new business platform towards sustainability is geared towards offering new alternatives for sustainable development. This attempts to create added value to the agricultural products. We have now expanded our factories and office branches to over 14 operations across Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, China, Indonesia, and Laos, and now export to more than 30 countries worldwide. We are committed to meeting their needs and developing our future to be a globally competitive and innovative leader from farm to shelf.
From the Philippines, UHS Essential Health Philippines, incorporated for direct selling industry.
Truly accepting this award is a great privilege and an honor, not just to me personally, but also to the organization that has been very much dedicated to the direct selling industry. Personally, it means a lot to me. 27 years ago, I competed for the Miss Asia Pacific in New Zealand. And now I am here again as a representative for the Asia Pacific. So this means a lot to me personally, but this time on the professional level. What does it mean for me, for our organization, and the industry that I love so much? I hope that I will be able to inspire not just employees and staff of this direct selling industry, but for all the leaders to truly embrace how we are being able to inspire other people and make a lot of significant difference in the lives of so many other people. So thank you very much. And I really hope that this is just the beginning.
U-Tech Zone for Semiconductor Industry from Taiwan. The company is the first automatic optical inspection manufacturer listed on Taiwan OTC market. With years of devotion in integrating machine vision into advanced inspection systems, U-Tech Zone successfully overturns the historical dominance of Western manufacturers and stands tall as the worldwide leader. And last but not least, Westports Malaysia Sendirian Berhad for transportation and logistics industry from Malaysia. Westports manages port operations dealing with containerized and conventional cargo. They serve as the main gateway for containerized and conventional cargo for the Central Peninsula Malaysia hinterland. Westports achieved a record-breaking productivity level by moving 801 containers in 1 hour with 12 ship-to-shore cranes on CMA CGM Jean Mermoz, an ultra-large container vessel that can accommodate 20,600 TEUs or 20-foot equivalent units. Currently, Westports is the 12th largest and busiest container port in the world. And with that, congratulations to all our winners. Let's give a big round of applause to congratulate all the winners from the Corporate Excellence category. Continuing the awards presentation, the next category is Inspirational Brand category. We this category are inspiring, transformational brands that seek to promote goodness, wellness, and/or sustainability. They are the heroes within the brand universe. The recipients of the APEA Inspirational Brand category in alphabetical order of the enterprises they represent are ACM Land Holdings Incorporated, for property development industry from the Philippines.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. For the past 29 years, ACM Homes consistently provides hardworking Filipinos with opportunities to own a home that they call their own. Despite the many challenges that this pandemic has brought for almost 18 months already, ACM remains steadfast and resilient in providing these opportunities and in delivering premium quality houses for home buyers in the affordable category. Therefore, to be recognized as an inspirational brand for a second year in a row in this Asia Pacific Entrepreneurship Award is truly, truly fulfilling and a validation of the ability of our organization to fulfill our value proposition to each and every ACM customer. With this, my sincere thanks to Enterprise Asia for this award and to all ACM personnel who play vital roles in making sure that the ACM brand's home is well recognized and appreciated. Thank you.
Up next is Bravo Ideas Digital Company Limited for telecommunications and ICT industry from Taiwan.
The 年轻人们因为偶像崇拜的关系，就会开始被他身上非常多的植入，开始产生购物的欲望。如何让大家看着影片的同时，能够快速的掌握这个消费型冲动？就我在看着视频的时候，能够直接让女主角一出来身上穿的、用的、戴的，看到就可以买到。它其实在做的一件事情，就是创造粉丝的经济。 那更重要的跨境线是一个很夯的一件事情，所以我们也会开始往东南亚。在今年第二季之前，东南亚会有7个国家陆陆续续上线，全球专利技术就是在台湾。那日本的专利刚好也是我们的，所以在今年我们也会把平台推向日本。但不要只一昧的去解决问题，而是去想另外一个方式如何创造需求。那个市场不要只着重于在台湾。 你真的能够创造需求之后，才会是走到全世界。我希望台湾其实可以更大的野心，去创造那个需求出来。我们的技术、我们的创意、我们的能量，我们真的很强。And
moving on is Chonghua Health Corporation for manufacturing industry from Taiwan. Let's take a look at their inspiring brand story. next is Far Glory Life Insurance Company Limited for financial services industry from Taiwan.
We at Far Glory Life are extremely honored to receive the Asia Pacific Enterprise Award. For more than 28 years in Taiwan, we are the life insurance business Far Glory Group and is committed to the development of Taiwan's life insurance market. We are dedicated and focused on having our customers live a stable life. Having a stable life is one part of our company's philosophy and purpose. We believe through dedicated efforts, while always keeping our humble beginnings in mind, Far Glory Life will join hands to build and realize dreams of our policyholders in Taiwan's every land where they exist.
Group of companies for food and beverage industry from the Philippines. Let's take a look at their inspiring brand story. Company Limited for hospitality, food service, and tourism industry from Taiwan.
智慧观光就是智慧城市的一个环节。风趣科技主要是提供目的地旅游资源管理平台，透过我们的公司所提供的这个平台服务，可以去整合一个目的地的相关的旅游资源，把所谓的旅游的产品或服务可以做电子化，分销到全球各地。
To create a more in-depth tourist experience, FonTrip intends to become the best technology partner for tourism and ICT-enabled services innovation. Cooperating with tourism businesses and integrating resources with the FonTrip platform, they have more than 22 overseas channels to sell Taiwan tourism destination products, including Japan, Korea, China, Hong Kong, and Southeast Asia, benefiting international tourists, but also helping to improve sales opportunities for local business.
国际化一定是我们最重要的一个未来的一个发展目标。风趣科技在这一两年也是在积极的去寻找海外的通路合作伙伴，这是我们第一步。那下一步就是我们希望把我们公司的这样平台的整合能量跟这样子的一个服务模式，能够有效的把它输出到海外，然后你也能够把海外目的地的商品上到平台，去有效的分销到国际的市场。
Metropolitan Electricity Authority for Energy Industry from Thailand.
Metropolitan Electricity Authority, or MEA. We strive for internationalization along with driving smart energy in Bangkok, Nonthaburi, and Sut Prakan. Smart Power, reliable power distribution system developed by the underground cable projects to serve communities' power consumption. Smart Service, digital services to make the customers meet over expected satisfaction and convenience. Smart Energy, develop green energy for a sustainable future. Smart Office, the new MEA head office, designed for environmental friendly workplace. We aim for enhancing people's well-being and uplifting the quality of the cities. MEA, energy for city life, energized smart living.
Biotechnology company limited for manufacturing industry from Taiwan.
自然美创办于1972年，近50年的传承与坚持，打造安全、自然、美丽、健康、专业的国际大品牌。
多年来，自然美携手世界顶尖美容科学团队，不断创新产品与技术。其中 ，ND1 系列获得哈佛 ND 生技 SCT 技术专利和美国领先发明专利。2019年，我们加入了专业顾问群作为强力后盾，同时不断升级高规格的生技研发中心和上海奉贤全球研发总部。都符合国际 ISO 认证与 SGS 合格检验标章。
细心呵护每位女性的肌肤是我们坚持的信念。自然就是美，东升自然美。
And moving on from Singapore, we have New Skin Southeast Asia for direct selling industry. Let's take a look at their inspiring brand story.
New Skin has been in business for more than 35 years. We have a global presence in nearly 50 markets around the world. We've grown to become a billion-dollar company listed on the New York Stock Exchange. New Skin has hundreds of innovative products that can help you look younger and live healthier. With more than 75 in-house scientists located in 2 global research centers and a world-class scientific advisory board,We've created products based on age-locked technology that are backed by science and created under strict quality standards. The result? A comprehensive range of products that offer anti-aging solutions that work from the outside in and from the inside out. Products that are loved and trusted by many all around the world. New Skin has become a global brand and has garnered more than 400 global awards. But it's more than just numbers.New Skin's Force for Good initiatives strive to improve the lives of children by helping them live a life full of hope in a bright future.
PCOM Online Incorporated for e-commerce industry from Taiwan.
在当社会停止运转时 PC Home 能仍然能够为大家把所需要的东西都送达，每一个细节，每一个只要他生活上有可能会用到的东西，我都希望我们有能力一点一点去建立起那个服务的系统来。 Everyday Reliable， 我希望我们每天都可靠，每天都跟大家在一起，这是我们的初衷，也是我们的使命，不管是过去、现在或未来。
Powershot Company Limited for consumer goods industry from Thailand.
The key formula for taking care of your body is getting enough exercise and choosing to consume all of the 5 food groups. This house was where the brand PowerShot was created. It all started with one phone and one person, wanting to share my story about how to take care of your body. Even if time is not on your side, each product was formulated to respond to the needs of our customers, which resulted in millions of sales in just a few months. Our main marketing motto is to listen to our customers and let them help shape our brand. This led to over $50 million in products sold in under a year. To our rapid growth, because learning to handle any obstacle thrown our way is key to achieve our brand mission, make a difference.
Rizal Commercial Banking Corporation, or RCBC, for financial services industry from the Philippines. Let's take a look.
RCBC has always been driven to serve with passion and purpose, with the end goal of promoting inclusive prosperity through innovative banking. We endeavor to always do better every day. And as the saying goes, excellence is a gradual result of always striving to do better. It is therefore with honor and a grateful heart that we accept this award. This is not just for RCBC, but also for all Filipinos whom we serve, who are proven resilient amidst the pandemic. Thank you to the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards for recognizing our efforts in empowering our people and enabling a sustainable digital Philippines. Mabuhay!
Shiny Brands Group Company Limited for cosmetic industry from Taiwan. Shiny Brands Group have been cultivated in the beauty industry for more than 10 years and has rapidly expanded its brand to more than 20 countries. The company upholds its concept of brand innovation responsibility with the most advanced stringent production to ensure the brand's beauty products are developed with effective cutting-edge technology that exceeds the market's expectations. International Limited for industrial and commercial products industry from Taiwan.
It's a huge honor for TENS International Limited to be awarded by APEA for Inspirational Brand Award 2021. Thank you very much for your recognition. TENS is a brand that has completely revolutionized the wood construction screw. With minimal effort, we can maximize the performance to save global energy and power. I think winning this award, it really gives us a motivation to continuously strive for efficiency, to create more innovative products, and to make a contribution to our environment. Some just see a screw. We see new possibilities.
TENS, joining wood.
And completing the award list for Inspirational Brand category is William Tools Company Limited for industrial and commercial products industry.
congratulations to all the winners in the Inspirational Brand category. Don't forget to give this live award ceremony a huge like if you are streaming from Enterprise Asia's Facebook or YouTube page. Without further ado, let's commence to the next category, the Fast Enterprise category. Under this category are the companies that demonstrated rapid growth in terms of revenue, market share, client base, profit, and/or brand recognition. Let's begin. And the awards of the Fast Enterprise category in APEA 2021 in alphabetical order are Bina Jaya Sindhuan Berhad for construction industry from Malaysia. Let's check out their video showcase.
That's all we are. The sun comes up and it goes back down. We search for love and it's love we found. We live our life now, we come this far. We won't stop now, this is all we are.
Intang Bulk Movers, Sindhuan Berhad, for transportation and logistics industry from Malaysia.
Hello everyone, on behalf of the Friendly Group of Companies, I would like to accept the recognition of Fast Enterprise Award from the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards Regional Edition. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the panel of judges for believing in us and our brands. Friendly Group of Companies started 7 years ago and now has 250 branches nationwide. We will continue to strive for excellence and provide the best products and service to our customers. Thank you.
Financial services industry from Singapore.
Hi, on behalf of MatchMove, I am proud to accept this award for the 2021 Fast Enterprise. At MatchMove, we strive to make what was once considered impossible, embedding finance into every app and mobile device. Not only possible, but inevitable. As we have expanded across Southeast Asia, and South Asia, and we have plans to serve the world in the next few years with our innovative banking as a service concept, the pace for change will only accelerate. Once again, thank you for the award, and we are very honored to have won it. Thank you. Bye bye.
Medicap Sindhugantra Hut for healthcare, pharmaceuticals, and biotechnology industry from Malaysia.
突破和扩展马来西亚现代医疗领域是我和团队想要做的事。大家好，我是林金豪，是Medicap的创办人兼执行董事。和大家所了解的医疗服务很大的不同。Medicap是一家整合医疗服务、保健中心还有洗肾中心为一体的综合性医疗。目前Medicap在全马有4间分行，分别是Brickfield、Sarikei、西部还有Bintulu。 而在Puchong、Kota Baru、还有科旺的分行正在装修。说到医疗，马来西亚人民只会想到生病了才去看医生。其实我们 Medicap 想要做到的是更全面的保健意识、医疗服务和健康教育。虽然只有短短的3年时间 ，Medicap 荣获了2020年金牛奖、新兴企业奖、中小型企业奖和中小型企业家奖。我们非常高兴。 获得业界对我们的认可，一起打造一个人性化、属于你我他的医疗总会。One
Universal Production Sindhugantra Berhad for Media and Entertainment Industry from Malaysia. From Malaysia, Pasaraya M.M. Sindhugantra Berhad for Retail Industry.
online incorporate for e-commerce industry from Taiwan. Let's check out their video showcase.
在当社会停止运转时 PC Home 能仍然能够为大家把所需要的东西都送达，每一个细节，每一个只要他生活上有可能会用到的东西，我都希望我们有能力一点一点去建立起那个服务的系统来。 Everyday Reliable， 我希望我们每天都可靠，每天都跟大家在一起，这是我们的初衷，也是我们的使命，不管是过去、现在或未来。
The Immigration People Private Limited for Professional and Business Services Industry from Singapore.
I'm Kay.
I'm Melina.
We are
the Immigration People.
We are very happy to win this Asia Pacific Enterprise Award under the Fast Enterprise Award category. It means a lot to us as it endorses our commitment and dedication to our business. Profitability is not the main driving force. We value our passion, professionalism, and ethics above all.
We are passionate about helping more and more deserving people achieve their Singapore immigration dream. And we appreciate the impact a red residency status can have on an individual, his family, and Singapore at large. Here in the Immigration People, we aspire to be the benchmark of service, quality, and integrity in the Singapore immigration industry.
Presenting the final recipient of the Fast Enterprise category, Viramid Electrical and Engineering Sintigran Berhad for Engineering Industry from Malaysia. Congratulations to all Fast Enterprise category winners. Let's give them a big thumbs up in the comment section and of course a big round of applause to all of these winners in our live chat. Moving on to the next award category, Master Entrepreneur category. These awards are presented to outstanding individuals who have demonstrated entrepreneurial attributes that make them role models for others, including tenacity and perseverance to continue innovating, making a difference under adverse situations and environments. And the winners of the APEA 2021 Master Entrepreneur category in alphabetical order of enterprises they represent are Dato Sri Victor Ki Lu Tien, Managing Director and Chairman of A Steel Sentirian Berhad for manufacturing industry from Malaysia.
It is my honor to be the recipient of Master Entrepreneur Awards. I am proud to lead SU Group to what we have achieved so far and where we are now. Receiving this award shows the testament on how far we have done and where what we have achieved. With this award, it motivates all of us and of course encourages us to continue towards improvement to all the aspects of our business. Most importantly, to continue operating with integrity. Winning this Master Entrepreneur Awards, the success is not able to be achieved by me alone, but with whole ASU Group employees, as they are the backbone of the companies. I am also receiving this award on behalf of them. Last but not least, on behalf of ASU Group, I would like to express the gratitude to all the panel judges for giving opportunities to share ASTEEL's best practices and our journey with you. Thank you.
Dato Minira Lui, founder and CEO of Grant International Sentirian Berhad for professional and business services industry from Malaysia.
Congratulations, team of Brand International, for winning this Corporate Excellence Award. So despite the pandemic and the challenges that we faced, you were able to achieve extraordinary results. For that, I want to extend my appreciation and thank you for your dedications, for your commitment and your pursuit for excellence, you know, in ensuring that the company achieved extraordinary performance. So once again, thank you and a well-deserved win.
We are Brand, making a difference and raising the bar for customer experience, one interaction at a time. That is our brand promise.
Moving on is Dennis Anthony Lee, founder and CEO of Converge ICT Solutions Incorporated for telecommunications and ICT industry from the Philippines.
It's an honor for me to be recognized by the Asian Pacific Enterprise Award as a master entrepreneur for the second year in a row. I started Converge several years ago with the goal to reach the underserved and unserved in the Philippines, to provide connection that is a par with our Asian neighbors. This award is the testament to the hard work and dedication that we have put in the building in the digital highway in the Philippines. I hope that this award will inspire other budding entrepreneurs to work hard, pursue their dreams, and help uplift the lives of others. Once again, thank you, APEA, for the award. Cheers!
MP Tsai, founder and CEO of eCloud Valley Digital Technology Company Limited for telecommunications and ICT industry from Taiwan. Tsai has led and piloted eCloud Valley to more than 8 overseas markets. He is one of the pioneers in the cloud industry in Taiwan and has successfully assisted thousands of organizations on digital transformation. Moving forward, Tsai plans to expand their reach cultivate cloud talents locally and be the innovation leader in the cloud industry. Sudhir Agarwal, founder and CEO of Everrise for professional and business services industry from Singapore. Let's take a look at his success story.
Hi, I'm Sudhir, the founder and CEO of Everrise, and I'm very pleased to be back here again with all of you. With the help of my all-star executive leadership team, we went to work on creating an award-winning culture that is now the envy of the industry. Today, we have 11,000 champions with a culture that is thriving, and it shows. Our Glassdoor ratings are 4.6 out of 5, and our NPS is 2 times that of industry average, according to Bain & Company. Through our dedication to diversity, 64% of Everrise is powered by women, and half of them are in leadership positions. Our people-first strategy has had a direct impact on our business. When the pandemic broke out last year, we were able to move our entire workforce from 12% to 90% in just over 50 days. Once again, thank you.
We are Everrise.
Avin C. Ong, founder, chairman, and CEO of Fredley Group of Companies for food and beverage industry from the Philippines. Let's check it out.
Hello everyone. I would like to accept the recognition of Master Entrepreneur Award from the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards Regional Edition. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the panel of judges for believing in me. This award is both an honor and a mission for me to inspire and empower aspiring entrepreneurs and to help build young business leaders across Asia. Thank you.
Dr. Ming C. Chuang, President of 4C Stem Cell Applied Technology Company Limited for healthcare, pharmaceutical, and biotechnology industry from Taiwan.
投入生技业五个年头的庄明熙应用在光电产业的实物经验导入细胞工程领域，让干细胞从源头的采集、分离、纯化、储存、放大制成、包装、检验、运送。 所有过程分段模组化，每项流程都取得专利技术。模组化的设计让实验室空间得以独立运作，产能规模提升5倍以上，成功让干细胞具备商业化的量产能力。
就是说，过去在生医或生技里面，它在细胞培养的时候，它的制程是一贯性的，很少人去做模组化。那我刚好就是，因缘际会，用这样的一个技术进来。
把它做一个大胆的尝试。台湾第一家以干细胞技术获得美国发明专利，目前已经有两支新药进入人体临床一期试验，迈向第二期。Up
next, we have Rama Shankar Pandey, Managing Director of Hella India Lighting Limited for Automotive Industry from India. As the youngest managing director of Hella India Lighting Limited, he turned around a decade-old loss-making entity to a sustainable business model and gave it a larger social purpose. He led the company to committing into road safety by launching affordable safety automotive products and enhancing awareness of risks on the road. He holds on to the vision of achieving entrepreneurial success by resolving real-life problems such as road deaths in the transport sector and building skilled youths from underprivileged, unemployed population, creating for 10 million youths in his lifetime. From Thailand, Kirapat Tiongsit, Governor of Metropolitan Electricity Authority for Energy Industry.
I am Kirapat Jemset, the governor of Metropolitan Electricity Authority. It is a great honor for us to be rewarded. We cannot achieve the rewards without the support from our board of directors and all the effort of my staff to deliver the excellent service and reliable power to our customers. Those are evident as why the customer trusts and recognizes our value. The rewards are very supportive for us. It has encouraged us to improve and transform our company into digital utility, and it also drives us to move into the smart and sustained energy for smart living in a smart society. Lastly, we would like to express our appreciation for the founder of Enterprise Asia to initiate and establish this award. And also thank you for all the administration staff judging committee to arrange and organize this reward successfully. I wish all of you to stay safe and healthy. Thank you.
Salat Lam Sam, President and CEO of Mong Thai Life Assurance Public Company Limited for financial services industry from Thailand.
On behalf of Mong Thai Life Assurance, I'm very grateful to know that we have been received the Corporate Excellence Award of 2021. On this year. It is something that we as a Mong Thai Life, we are so proud of. This award has meaningful to all of us in a way that the world has changing a lot with all the dynamic environment, including all the COVID-19 effect that also having a lot of the challenging and also opportunity on this thing. By receiving this award, it's something that, I mean, to us, it's something that what we are doing, it is probably something on the right direction, and it's something to give as a incentive back to ourselves that we are doing something on the right way on this thing. So thanks a lot to all the judges and all the people that giving on this award to us, and we also very committed that what we are doing is to the best of the policyholder and to the best of all the Thai people, or if we have a chance to answer to or the ASEAN country also on this thing. So thanks a lot.
Nazir Ahmad Muhammad Zakiria, founder and managing director of Nazmi Textile Mall for retail industry from Brunei. Let's take a look at his success story.
Nazir Ahmad Muhammad Zakaria is the founder and managing director of Nazmi Textile Mall. Nazir opened his very own first textile shop in 1992 in Bandar. In the year 2000, Nazir opened his flagship outlet at the Delima Jaya complex, the art market and high-end mall dedicated to merchandising, textiles and fabrics. Today, Nazir runs a business empire with 13 outlets in Brunei. Nazmi Textile Mall is present in several notable complexes across the country. Plus, the exclusive Nazmi Kaira Fashion House, Home of Textile, Economy and Home Decor. The textile empire employs close to 100 staffs. In 2004, Nazir was elected as president of the Indian Chamber of Commerce in Brunei Darussalam. Nazir is also a generous benefactor to various charity organizations and the underprivileged.
Wanni Nila Wechabu, founder and CEO of Neo Target Company Limited for professional and business services industry from Thailand. Neo Target was established in 2002. Unlike any regular PR agency, the company provides reputation consulting, content, strategy, and other services. Wanni has foreseen that good corporate reputation is vital to organizations. Thus, she readjusted Neo Target's business model to focus on sustainable reputation management services. Under her leadership, Neo Target has entered an alliance with one of the largest PR consultancies in Singapore.
Next up, Chuwik Jintana Sombun, CEO of Northeast Rubber Public Company Limited for Agriculture Industry from Thailand.
ขอบพระคุณทุกท่านนะครับที่มอบรางวัลอันทรงเกียรตินี้ให้กับผมนะครับกับผมเองมีความภูมิใจที่ได้รับรางวัลนี้มากนะครับแล้วมีความตั้งใจแล้วก็มีแรงบันดาลใจที่จะขยายงานต่อไปเพื่อที่จะสร้างความเข้มแข็งให้ชุมชนที่อยู่รอบข้างเรา ให้อยู่กับเราอย่างมีความสุขและมีความยั่งยืนอย่างที่สุดนะครับอย่างเช่นการจ้างงานที่เรามีการทำอยู่ต่อเนื่องตลอดเวลานะครับและเราจะมีการทำระบบซีโร่เวสต์ในโรงงานเราเพื่อให้ชุมชนที่อยู่รอบข้างเรามีความสุขในการอยู่มากขึ้นกว่าเดิมนะครับจากการที่สภาพแวดล้อมในรอบๆข้างจะไม่มีมลภาวะหรือว่าไม่มีมลพิษเกิดขึ้นเลยนะครับก็ขอขอบคุณทุกท่านอีกครั้งหนึ่งครับขอบพระคุณมากครับ
Kevin Tsai, CEO and General Manager of Pecom Online Incorporated for e-commerce industry from Taiwan.
Hi, 大家好，我是 Pecom 执行长蔡凯文。这次非常感谢亚洲企业商会的肯定，我不仅感觉非常荣幸，也觉得身负重任。
全球受 COVID 疫情的影响，台湾也同样面临考验。我们相信网购是当今社会停止运转的时候一个很重要的备援机制。秉持着 Everyday Reliable 的坚定， PCOM 始终陪伴大家把需要的商品都送达每个人的手中。面对未来， PCOM 始终相信坚持创新，勇敢地迎向挑战，以实现在地共生共好的经营理念，达成企业长期获利目标。我也会持续站在最前线，希望能为大家带来正面的力量。再次谢谢这个奖项的肯定。
Ang Ken Chun, Managing Director of Pilot Construction Sembilan Berhad for Construction Industry from Malaysia.
首先我很感谢 APEA 对 Pilot 的认可，让我有机会获得这个企业家奖项，我感到非常荣幸而开心，因为这是对人工和公司的一种肯定和很大的鼓励。这次得奖让我们朝向更前面的方向努力，把企业做得更大更好更远。回顾我的个人的旅程和白的成长，我充满了感激和自豪感，和确保我们说什么就做什么，发挥了重要作用。但作为领导者和队友，我们总是乐于助人和诚信做事。我很感谢我的员工，因为他们坚持的信念有助于我们的客户建立牢固的关系。
Hachara C. Benjama, founder of PowerShot Company Limited for consumer goods industry from Thailand.
Hi, my name is Hachara C. Benjama, but Thai people know me by my nickname, Kalaman.
I have been a news reporter, author, and TV host.
I believe that hard work, discipline, consistency,is the key to success.
Physical health has always been a priority in my life. This is why I am constantly researching how to stay fit and pass on my experience to others whenever I can, even through live streams for those who are far away from me.
I know every success and growth in my life has been assisted by everyone around me.
For the past 2 years, me and my team have done CSR campaigns to give back to the world.
Finally, I would like to thank Asia Pacific Enterprise Board. This will be crucial drive and motivation for our team to improve and strive.
Vishal Tulsian, President Director and CEO of PT Bank Amar Indonesia, TBK, for financial services industry from Indonesia.
So first of all, thank you for this award. I thank to the jury of APEA for giving us this award. We started this journey back in 2014 with a belief that technology must improve lives, and we built a new business model. And this award validates that it is possible to build a successful business model while doing some social good. So thank you for again. So as any award, as any validation, this definitely makes you feel very good. What it is more important to recognize is that this is not a one-person job. This is the job of the whole team. So as a representative of the team, I come here and I can thank from the behalf, on the behalf of full team, to recognize our effort and award us with this.
Kumar Manokaran, founder and managing director of Viramid Electrical and Engineering Sendirian Berhad for engineering industry from Malaysia. Let's take a look at his success story. Founder and chairman of William Tools Company Limited for industrial and commercial products industry. So let's take a look at his success story.
Hey, 特点是成立于1999年。 当初成立的时候是只专注于吉轮扳手。 吉轮扳手是在套筒组里面的灵魂工具，在产品研发，我们有坚强的研发团队。 1999年我就是开发这一支 流线的品，一般的吉轮扳手都是冷冷冰冰的，几乎没有设计。我当初我创立特点的时候就是开发这一支，这一支看起来是不是觉得就很漂亮，握起来 就有软软的很舒服的感觉，稍微有一点流线，所以握起来，感觉不错，也不会手不会受伤。And
finally, last but certainly not least, we have Ang Li Liang, founder and managing director of Yu Li Pacific Manufacturer Sendirian Berhad for manufacturing industry from Malaysia.
A revolutionized manufacturer that produces brushes using the sophisticated industrial technique, while exploring new ideas. Yu Li Pacific Manufacturer functions in a facility that was designed and built around unique brush manufacturing requirements, allowing for maximum efficiencies and workflow. This combination of machineries and factory layout enabled us to export to many countries around the world. Our products can be always delivered in their best condition and error-free as a result of our severe in every quality control test.
This is truly an honor for me to accept this entrepreneur award from APEA this year in 2021. I have always worked on the policy that we must always keep our word and what we have committed to do for our customer. We must make it happen. I would like to take this opportunity to thank to all my staff, customer and suppliers for their support all this year. I am successful because of their support and contributions. Once again, thank you very much.
Congratulations to all the winners in the Master Entrepreneur category. Give yourselves a massive round of applause. Congratulations on an amazing job well done. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to present to you the final award of the evening, Entrepreneur of the Year. This award is presented to extraordinary individuals that have shown outstanding ingenuity and are recognized as first amongst equals. These awards are given to truly deserving recipients, and only one winner is honored for each category, for each industry, in every country. being an iconic individual for the esteemed recognition of the Entrepreneur of the Year Award. The Entrepreneur of the Year Award honors a business leader who is an emblem of inspiring success. He is the third generation leader of a multinational conglomerate with businesses across energy, building and industrial systems, healthcare, transportation, lifestyle, real estate, digital and capital partners. His leadership has led the company to be listed in 2017, earning over $860 million in revenue in its first year. He is also touted as one of the country's foremost philanthropists, as he plays an engaging role in supporting the World Wildlife Fund's programs and reforestation across the country while keeping in line with his company's compassionate philosophy. He's led the company with the vision empowering the world compassionately and is focused to accomplish his long-term goal to be a carbon neutral company by 2050 with renewable energy, decarbonization, and smart grids to green hydrogen production. Today, under his leadership, the company has grown to be one of the country's fastest growing industrial and renewable power producers. Ladies and gentlemen, the recipient of the Entrepreneur of the Year Award for the energy industry is Dr. Harold Link, Chairman and President of Vigrim Power Public Company Limited from Thailand. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it once again. Our heartiest congratulations, of course, goes out to this year's Entrepreneur of the Year. And ladies and gentlemen, with that, the Asia Pacific Enterprise Awards 2021 Regional Edition is slowly coming to an end. Once again, we would first, of course, like to thank all our incredible partners for making this possible. So a big thank you goes out to PR Newswire, APEA 2021's news release distribution partner. Our supporting organizations, Angel Investment Network Indonesia, Indian Chamber of Commerce, Indonesian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Institut Keusahawanan Negara Berhad, Malaysian Investment Development Authority, Malaysian Thai Chamber of Commerce, Ministry of Entrepreneur Development and Cooperatives, National Institution of Entrepreneurship and Innovation Cambodia, Singapore Thai Chamber of Commerce, SME Corporation, the Malaysian Chamber of Commerce Hong Kong and Macau Limited. And not forgetting, a big thank you as well to our media partners: Business World the Philippines, Commercial Times Taiwan, Daily Tribune the Philippines, Hong Kong Economic Times, Jumpstart Hong Kong, Kumparan Indonesia, New Delhi Times India, SME Magazine, The Nation Thailand, The Standard Hong Kong, and last but certainly not least, a huge thank you to our official production partner, Avangardia Group Sabdiran Berhad. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, give yourselves a big pat on the back. Of course, to all our award recipients, congratulations on an amazing job, well done. Now, while we might all be in different countries, in different cities, in different time zones, but if we are all united in the belief that we can continue to contribute and further cultivate the entrepreneurial world sustainably, we are already in the progress in leaving our legacy behind. So until we physically see you all next year, remember to stay safe, continue your remarkable contributions as you have done so far. And once again, thank you for joining us this evening. I'm Nadia Heng, wishing you all the very best of luck in all your endeavors, and I hope you all have a splendid evening ahead. Take care, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll see you all again next